Whoa! What's going on, guys? Tyson Anderson, Mr. Hammer Down. Listen, guys, back out here in big bad Briar Country. That's right, with the old little pup here. Hey, listen, guys. The deer hunters versus the rabbit hunters. Won't be before you long, but I will be before you strong. Listen, it's been a collision of the hunt for the beast for many years, decades even, right? Where those guys that spent all hunting season or off season trying to dial in those rabbit dogs, those beagles, so forth and so forth, trying to get to that opening day. Well, at one time it was in November, then it backed up, so forth and so forth. Now it's October 17th for the North Carolina rabbit season, pardon me. Well, I'll tell you what that does, it's a little cold, to both the deer hunter and the rabbit hunter, it causes them to collide, right? A lot of guys are buck crazy. They're looking for that huge antler, you know, that giant doe, mainly that buck, right? And so, you know, a huge conflict of interest takes place, right? Takes place. And if we're not careful, the dogs could get shot. We could get shot. People are very territorial when it comes over their comes to their deers, and as well as those that passionately follow their dogs. Pardon me. I would like to sort of raise an awareness, and I don't know what we're going to do it this year because we're already in the hunting season, but at some time or another, I would love for you guys to partner with me, and let's sort of try to attack this colliding element, right? I think if the rabbit hunters and the deer hunters show a mutual respect to one another, this is God's country. We all are in it. There's no big I's and little U's. I'm not more important than you because I have 900 subscribers. You're not more important than me because you have 1 million. You know, I'm not less because I'm black. You're not more because you're white or this or that or whatever, right? Because this person's gay or whatever, I'm above them. No, we all have a right to be here. We all have a right to openly speak our mind. And because of that, I want to sort of come on here briefly just as a filler and raise that awareness. A lot of guys talk about it amongst themselves and in those various groups, but we don't usually verbalize our feelings. That we verbalize privately, we don't verbalize publicly. We don't use our platforms to go into details to speak about the things that are plaguing, this world, this life. And I'm not talking about grassroots America, I'm talking about the outdoor world and industry. At one time or another, harvesting a deer was more than just antlers. It was more than just antlers. Don't you run that, okay? If you do, you'll feel number 6 for a long time in the end of my belt. But anyway, it was more than just antlers. It was more than just, you know, the horns. It was about putting meat in the freezer. There was a different pursuit of happiness. At that time, it was more of survival. Right? They had to do it because they wanted to eat, and they would use the hunting season to carry them over into the off season and so forth, right? They would make their jerkies and their sausages and their gumbos and their roasts and all of these different things, their stews. Well, the same exists with that of rabbit. Dove, quail, pheasant, woodcock, grouse, all of those things, all those migratory birds, ducks. And so we are in this together, folks. I need you, you need me. Maybe not specifically Tyson, maybe not specifically John Doe, but I need you, you need me. We are interdependent of one another. We have to learn how to coexist. Our forefathers did it. We can do it if we try. The world can be so much of a better place. And again, I'm talking about the outdoor world. If we merge and come together. Hey man, I'm hunting this property over here, 300 acre property over there. I know you cut the lanes, and I know you're always in there in the off season, but you know, I paid to lease it in this portion of the hunting season for deer. I like to get in there and, you know, kill some deer. It's a heavy little bugger. And kill some deer, his foot was in my pocket. And so forth. And so we respect that, right? We respect that, and we come together and say, you know what? Okay, you're right, John Doe. You're right, Billy. You're right, Timmy. I'm gonna stay out of there. I'm in Briar Country right now. You guys know how adamant I am about running Briar Country. I haven't shot in here not one time. When the deer season opened up, 3 or 4 days before it opened, the owners of this property, great people, great friends of mine, told me, hey, we know you ran all year. We've cut the lanes. If you can, stay out of there as much with the dogs and making a lot of noise with the dogs and shooting, because we really want to take some bucks or some good does, whichever presents themselves. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. No problem. Not just because this is their property. If it were not their property and it was someone else's property, but we were mutual users of this property, it would still be yes, sir. Yes, sir, because I understand we both have a passion to do this thing. They're not in it just for big trophy bucks. They're in it for putting meat on the table. I'm in it for putting meat on the table, furthering the education and development of my dogs and others' dogs and so forth, but I'm a hunter first and foremost. I love to partake in the eating of rabbit, right? So there's a way around it. Some guy, I can't stand them deer hunters. I wish they leave. And then some people are saying them darn rabbit hunters, them little dogs making all that noise. Listen, we're in this thing together, guys. We're in this thing together, gals. Whether we like it or not, we're in this thing together. We are interdependent of one another. Rabbit hunters, respect the deer hunters. Deer hunters, all we ask is you respect us as well. If we can come to a mutual agreement, guess what? Find that common ground, which is the outside, the outdoors, and that beat to the drum. If we can do that, we can shape this outdoor world and make it a better place. I've got a young son, and I'm waiting for him to get up in some age so he can take the reins over, because I won't be young forever. Young people, cherish your youth. The older folks will tell you this that's older than me, they wish they had. Some of them did. And that's why some of them are able to say, I'm 85 and I'm 90 years old, still getting out there in the woods. I want you guys to hunt safe. Remember to take a kid hunting. Shoot true. Make sure you've got a good shot. There's no persons in your way. Be respectful and remindful of those deer hunters. Be respectful and mindful, of those rabbit hunters. Right? We need one another. If we do that, I believe God will continue to keep us. And this outdoor thing, well, it won't seem so cliche and far-fetched. And hopefully, we'll continue to be able to run. Hopefully, we'll continue to be able to hunt and bear arms. Till next time, guys. Tyson Anderson. Mr. Hammer Down. And he said, we'll see ya. I'm not turning. I'm when we see you. For a land let's go, pup. Far away beside the crystal mountain. So come with me, we'll go and see the big rock candy mountains. In the big rock candy mountains, there's a land that's fair and bright, where the handouts grow on bushes and you sleep out every night, where the boxcars all are empty and the sun shines every day on the birds and the bees and the cigarette trees, the lemonade springs where the bluebird sings in the Big Rock Candy Mountains.